Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to demonstrate a complete guide on AWS SSH key pair. Let's talk about the different key pairs that AWS is supporting. As of today, AWS is supporting for two type of key pairs, ED25519 and RSA. Starting from 17th August 2021, AWS started supporting for ED25519, which is more robust, more performance and more secured key pair type compared to RSA. Let's see how the key pair works in AWS. When you have created an SSH key pair in AWS cloud, it actually creates a public key and private key. You also have the option to choose the type of the key as ED25519 or RSA. And we have option to choose the format of the key as .pem or .ppk. .pem is the compatible key for Linux or Mac OS distributions, and .ppk is the Windows-based PuTTY compatibility. When you have created an key pair, the private key will be get downloaded to your local workstation, and when you have associated the key pair to the EC2 instances, the public key will be get copied to the EC2 instances to the default location authorized underscore keys. When you as a client trying to authenticate to the EC2 instances, you must be attaching the private key to your SSH client. Then you will be connecting to the EC2 instances over the network. SSH service, which is actually running on the EC2 instance, will ensure that the right private key is attached to the request before it actually grant the permission to connect it to the EC2 instances. Let's talk about a few important notes related to the key pair. You can create 5000 key pairs per region. RSA is the default type of the SSH key pair, and ED25519 key does not support for Windows based EC2 instances. Also, ED25519 key is only available to download in .pem format from AWS. Also important to note, if you lost the key pair, you cannot download the key pair again from AWS. Good that we have good understanding about the key pair. Now let's get on to AWS management console to see where is the options to download the key pair and how to associate the key pair to the EC2 instances. Log into AWS management console, go to services, click on EC2 service, click on running instances. To create a new EC2 instance, click on launch instance, select the AMI, select instance type. I'm not going to talk about how to create a EC2 instance in this video. I'm just following the default options to create an EC2 instance, as we are targeting to understand about the key pair association. We can choose the existing key pair that is already available, and you can see the key pairs that are of RSA or ED25519. If you wanted to create a new key pair, you can choose create a new key pair and select the key pair type, specify the key pair name, and click on download the key pair. Now you see .pem format private key is downloaded to your local workstation. Now click on launch instances. Click on view instances. Create a key pair explicitly not at the time of launching a EC2 instance. You can always go to the key pair option in the EC2 service. Click on create a key pair. Specify the key pair. Now you get an option to choose the key pair type as RSA or ED25519. If you are downloading the RSA type of key, you get an option to choose the key format as .pem or .ppk. However, if you are choosing the type as ED25519, by default it downloads the PEM format key, you do not have an option to download .ppk. Let me download the key pair. However, you see that the demo1-key is downloaded as ppk, and if you look into the key here, the key is actually created of type RSA, though I have chosen the type as ED25519. I am sure this is a bug at the moment at AWS side. Hence, it is recommended to create a ED25519 type of key at the time of you launching a EC2 instance process, rather creating it from the key page section until AWS is fixing this issue. I am sure you are curious by now how to connect it to EC2 instances when you lost the private key, since you cannot download the key pair one more time from AWS. I will be showing you workaround in my next video. Please do subscribe for more updates. Thank you.